This is Josh Olmsted. Welcome back to Northwest Disc Golf's coverage of the first ever Northwest Amateur Championships presented by Innova at the Shelton Springs Disc Golf Course in Shelton, Washington. Hope you enjoyed our front nine coverage. Nine holes to go as these guys compete for one of the richest prizes in amateur disc golf, an all-expenses-paid trip for them and a caddy to the United States Amateur Disc Golf Championships in Michigan. We got Cory Jones with a one-stroke lead over Jacob Dills and Mike Mayer heading into the final nine. Hole 10, we've got a 525-foot par 4, sharp dogleg right with a mando left right off the tee, keeping people from cutting through the forest.
Michael Henson, 74898.
As you can see, it's a pretty tight window, and they've really got to get it out there into the fairway, try to get as far right as they can, make the second shot a little bit more manageable.
Mike Mayer, number 72879.
Mike's the only player going with a backhand on the tee, a much harder shot.
Jacob Dills, 71769.
Jacob will follow with a forehand of his own.
Yeah.
He has a great drive. Thought that might skip a little bit more.
Corey Harrison, Vincent Jones, PDGA number 59870.
Cory throwing all his forehands with that Prodigy Proto X1. Has a pretty good drive of his own. Mike starting off the back nine with more of that overhand magic, and he manages to throw a great shot. That's almost to the entrance back into the trees, so he'll have a chance to save his par. Cory looks like he chopped down a branch, doing a little course maintenance. Hard to see, but there's a window right in the middle. The basket is tucked about 80 feet back into the forest. There it is, you can see. So Mike Mayer gonna try another forehand, and he just is magic with those. He'll have a chance to putt for his four. Runs a nice jump putt, just a little short. Much like the front nine, you'll see that there is all woods all the way here. There aren't any really easy holes on this black tee course as Jacob clears up a great birdie. Any birdies are good here. Evens a pretty highly rated score. But these guys know that there are players on the chase card who can definitely go under, so they're going to have to get some birdies on the back nine if they're going to want to hold on to the lead. So Jacob gets the lone birdie. Mike cleans up a nice save. No real movement. Michael Henson with a one-stroke lead going into hole 11. Hole 11, we have a 285-foot par 3. This is probably the signature hole on the course, possibly with the exception of some of the beautiful par 5s. This is the only island green on the course. Generally, there's not a lot of out of bounds here, so it's a very unique shot. The hole plays actually like a moat, so that it's in bounds, and then there's about a 60-foot wide OB ring with another inner island that is in bounds. Michael lays it up short, and Mike will do the same, cutting through a local route. Looks like Corey's taking his putter. He is also just laying up safe.
His route looked kind of fun.
Definitely a very fun risk-reward shot. Debating whether or not you want to go for the green on your first. Michael will attempt to get on the green here. He comes up short, hits the log. Rough way to go on this hole. He'll be taking his fourth shot from the drop zone. It's about an 80-foot drop zone off to the left on this hole. Great upshot. Here's Jacob from that drop zone, just misses his long par attempt. And Michael with the bogey attempt, he also comes up a little short. So no one's able to take advantage of the relatively short hole, but Mike and Cory will get pars. They'll gain a stroke, as Michael will drop two strokes with that double bogey. He's probably not happy with that.
My heel is within the circle that this is.
So Michael, Mike, and Jacob all drop into a three-way tie for second on the card. Cory Jones leading the way at 6 under par. These guys just keep shuffling around leaders in this final round. So par hole 12, it's a 340-foot par 3. Now we're definitely getting into the tightest part of the forest. It's a trio of really difficult, though reachable, par 3s. So gentle sloping dogleg right. Let's see, Mike's trying to get that to play the soft Anheuser fade. Fades out a little early, but he'll have an easy par from there. Happy with that. Cory with his X1 forehand. Comes up short, hits the trees on the left. Jacob with a nice line. Cuts through everything. He'll have a 35-foot putt from the bushes. Good chance for birdie here. Michael follows it up with a turnover shot, although I think his rolled out on the right side. Cory showing off that he's not the only one on the card with a good overhand. Comes up a little short though. I want to take a moment to mention Olympic discs. All the players I talked to and the TD all mentioned how big their support was for the tournament. They're the ones responsible for the full ride top prize, the all expenses paid trip to Michigan. Olympic Discs, it's a local disc golf store in the area. You can look them up online. They are the biggest provider of discs out in the West Sound area. Innova provided a hero bag to everyone who played. So between Innova Discs and Olympic, they were able to really make this a very lucrative event for the AM players. So Cory and Michael will both take pars here, with Mike cleaning up a bogey. Sorry, Mike and Jacob get pars, with Michael and Cory ending up with bogeys on the hole. So it's a three-way tie at 5 under par. Going into hole 13. Hole 13 is another dogleg right, the third in a row on this back nine. Definitely a bit of a lefty course. I find a lot of courses tend to have more dogleg lefts. So definitely challenges your turnover shots, challenges your forehand shots for these right-hand players. As Mike will demonstrate off the tee. 315, this is just the third shortest hole on the black tee course. 315, third shortest hole. You can tell this is definitely a long course, over 8,000 feet. Cory flipping over another forehand with that X1. He knows he needed to get that further to the right. Michael hits an early tree. Got a good sense of humor, which I think you need in this Shelton forest.
Oh, the kick from hell. Oh.
You can see there's a wall of trees about 60 feet shy of the basket, so on your upshot, you really are trying to get through there, get it up to the pin, as Jacob shows. That's a great upshot from him. Drop in putt. Cory with his PA4. He's got about a 30-foot putt. And Mike with another tomahawk there. His 145 DX Destroyers. I just can't get over that disc. That's too cool. So here's Cory for his par. And again, he chains out on the right side. Getting no love from these Chainstar baskets today. Michael will do the same, straddle putt from around the trees. Starting to show a little frustration. Cory taps out his bogey.
All I know is I'm 3 miles.
So Jacob and Mike holding on to a one-stroke lead over Cory on this back nine as we move on to hole 14. We're moving back into the long holes. This one is a 775-foot monster, a true par 5 with all of the woods. Now, you might think that a par 5 at 775 feet might be easy, but not here at Shelton. This is every bit of a par 5, as you have to navigate a long corridor of trees. This is really going to test your ability of to put a laser shot down there. Jacob comes up left on his drive, hyzers out. Cory with that signature standstill drive gets it to flip over. That could work out, and that's a good shot.
That's tough. They shouldn't have been standing there.
Really, if you can just get this shot 300, 355 feet down the tunnel, makes this hole very approachable. But if you hit something early like Michael Henson did here, suddenly the hole gets a whole lot harder, and it just becomes pinball in the trees. It's definitely a course that really tests your technical game. How accurate can you be? How consistent can you be? How many mistakes can you avoid? I feel like is sort of the theme on this course. Definitely a change of pace from the birdie fest you might see on a lot of other tournament courses. Cory trying a forehand roller just misses that large tree.
Yeah, I almost died on that. So.
But it sounds like it bounced off a rock just behind the tree. Doesn't get too far.
Come on.
Michael Henson, four shots in a row off the trees. He's just looking to have anything go clean on this hole. As he has given up a good number of strokes.
Beautiful.
In the last few holes, and that's a great shot. He really needed that to stay in it on this back nine. He'll be able to tap that out for a six. Cory going backhand. Plays a little bit of a hyzer flip, but catches some late trees. I feel like at this point, the players must be wishing that they were still playing on that shorter course. Cory running another good jump putt. He's got great form on those jump putts. As Jacob lays up an 80-footer, Mike looks to run this. Comes up a little bit left on that. Cory puts that center chains after that last hole just to make sure it stays in. So Mike ends up getting a birdie, quietly sneaking up to take the lead on this card. It's a great four. So at 6 under, he leads the lead card. Michael is now just 1 under par after an unfortunate string of holes. He was 7 under, just about 4 holes back. So hole 15, another reachable par 3, 325 feet, slight dogleg to the right. Pretty straightforward hole on this back nine. So there's Mike with his tomahawk.
Oh, you're an animal.
Get some nice commentary. I'm sure the rest of the card is enjoying watching those great thumbers and tomahawks from Mike. Manages to sneak through. Jacob's a little short, he's about 60 feet shy. The big obstacle on this hole is there's a bunch of logs right in front of the pin that really force you to stay high on your shot, really grab any discs that if you're trying to skip it in. Kind of forces players to throw a little bit more area of a shot. So you can see Michael's going to get
in the middle,
caught up by the low stuff. very pretty backdrop to this hole. Kind of see the sun peeking out there. And that's a beautiful shot. Balanced on the pin. Excellent upshot. Cory puts one up pretty close. Here's Jacob for a huge birdie. Great putt. We'll definitely need to see that one again on replay. As Jacob shows, he doesn't need a jump putt to make a long 60-footer. Just stands and delivers. Great snap. Nice pickup on this hole. Any birdies are going to feel pretty good at Shelton. That one looked a little high. Cory got it to stay in there. Mike taps in his par. So Jacob Dills gets the lone deuce to draw into a tie for the lead with Mike Mayer. Although with three holes to go, these guys are going to need a few more birdies if they want to challenge the chase card. A lot of players were having some hot scores. Everyone trying to put together their best to win that top prize here. So we move on to hole 16, 345 feet, another reachable par 3, sort of some of the only birdie opportunities here on this back nine. This one curves a little bit harder, so these players are going to have to switch up and play their forehand shots. Mike going with a, look like a forehand roller. It's just showing off that it's safe. Didn't get too far though. Cory with a lot of snap. That's a beautiful forehand. Michael Henson hoping for it to get through, and it does. He takes the sharp inside line. And he's parked.
Wow.
Mike with another tomahawk upshot. That's a beautiful shot. Jacob will just lay up and take his three. This dusty ground on 16 makes, and Cory sinks a huge birdie. I think we're going to need to watch another one on replay here. Take a look, see how he does it. Throws that powerful jump putt. That just never left the chains. That's straight in. Let's see if Mike can follow up. Comes up a little short. Michael with a beautiful birdie. He's happy to get one back, stop the bleeding on this back nine. So moving on to hole 17, Cory with the birdie, Michael with the birdie, and Mike ends up dropping a bogey to drop out of the lead here on this lead card. Jacob moves ahead with 6 under par. Hole 17, 370 feet, dogleg left. This is a really hard hole. You'll see it's a really tight tunnel. I think this hole plays a lot longer than 370. It's really a full two-shot par 3. These guys are just trying to get it as far down the fairway as they can.
Yeah.
Mike with an aggressive hyzer flip. He's really trying to crunch that. Great shot. That might be up there with a look at for the two. Jacob, that was just starting to flip over for him. Mike, once again, taking some of the sneakiest lines on this card. He just manages to fit through the smallest windows. It's a nice Anheuser putter approach on that. Thumber.
Nice.
Great upshot. Oh, tickles the chains. That was for birdie. That would have been an awesome deuce. Here's Mike for his deuce. Can't quite get it in. So, card will look to just take pars. Mike Mayer gets the unfortunate bogey on 17. Jacob will clean up his bogey. Okay, going into our final hole. Three players tied at minus five. We've got a huge par five to see who can beat out the lead card here. 705 feet. The second par five on the back nine and the third one on the course. It's the shortest of the three par fives, but that doesn't mean it's easy. There's OB down the left side. There's an OB zone long, bordered by a fence. And there's an elevated pin position. You can see they're just trying to get out. You can see there's where those two people are standing. There's an open field out there that gives you an easy shot back into the pin. But it is a good 450 feet to get there. Oh, Michael. That's an unfortunate OB because that was a beautiful drive. That's definitely the longest drive on the card. Jacob Dills hoping for that to come back, but it is not wanting to. Cory will take a forehand roller, pops over the bush, fan jumps out of the way, and that's a great shot. He'll have a nice chance to get a birdie four to finish. It's only about 200 feet to the basket from there. Mike with a nice shot of his own. Very nice work. So here's Michael from the drop zone. He tosses a nice high hyzer shot, cutting in. Drops down a little early though. The pin is tucked way back in there. Feel like it wouldn't be Shelton without finishing with one more tight protected green. Cory with a beautiful tomahawk, getting some commentary from the gallery. Mike gets cut down there on his hyzer putter approach. So here's Cory for a birdie four. He's got a long putt at it. Oh, and he hits the cage. Great run from Cory. That would have been a great way to finish the round. Oh, Jacob as well. Huge putts. You can tell these guys are just so close to making some of those big putts. Here's Michael Henson for an OB par. He'll tap out a 6P on the last hole. Yep. Three pars on the card. And Cory will actually be tapping out a bogey, I believe. Great work from the lead card. Cory takes a bogey, so Jacob Dills and Mike Mayer finish at 5 under par, but it turns out it's not going to be good enough. A lot of great rounds from the chase card. Curtis Snyder ends up taking it. He shot a 6 down on the black tee course for a 1,007 rated round. Matt Zlatich shoots a 990 rated round to take second, and Jordan Broadwell shoots a 982 to finish third.
We had quite the epic battle this weekend for our Advanced Men Championship. It came down to a third place victory gets to take the full ride because the other two guys have already accepted cash. Extremely competitive battle this weekend. Look at the scorecards. You guys did an amazing job. Congratulations, all three of you. Coming in third place and taking the full ride, a full expense paid trip by Olympic Disc, going to the United States Amateur Disc Golf Championship in Michigan. Jordan Broadwell. Second place, winning in an epic battle, Matthew Zlatich. hometown favorite and champion, Curtis Snyder.
Speeches.
Speech!
Hey, I want to say thanks to Olympic Discs. Guys, Mason County.
Everyone out here. Everyone did a great job putting on the tournament. I want to thank everyone out here, all the support. It was a great tournament. Thank you guys.
Thank my sponsors, Chapsleeve. Thanks, guys.
So that's it for our coverage. Please don't forget to thumbs up our video and subscribe to the channel so you can make sure you won't miss any of our fantastic disc golf action. You can see we've got the Fort Silicon Open final round. We've got the Disco Ball final round down in Central Oregon. Lots of great tournaments. Stay tuned.